In our series on the science of soil health, there's been a lot of emphasis on soil biology. But what about the simple relationship between water and carbon dioxide in the soil? Let's hear a little bit more from Dr. Will Brinton on this subject.
Well, the rhizosphere around the roots is particularly enriched because there are nutrients that and exudates coming off of the roots. Although we shouldn't think of terms of plants being extremely leaky, but they are naturally partly leaky and the microbes benefit. But all microbes are respiring. So they're producing CO2, and I've indicated it builds up in the soil and then starts diffusing out. But guess what concentrations it reaches in the soil? This is what's so interesting. If you put a CO2 probe and bury it in the soil, and we've done all these studies, we're talking 3 to 10,000 parts per million CO2 in the airspace. But it doesn't just sit there in the airspace, it dissolves in the water and forms carbonic acid.
Okay.
Carbonic acid is one of the oldest studied organic acids that can be discussed. At least it comes from the decaying organic matter. But it forms like a 0.1 molar solution in the soil. And what is that doing? It's weathering minerals. It's a gentle weathering agent to release potassium, particularly, and trace elements from all the mineral structure in the soil. So plants are creating CO2 in an envelope around their roots through the rhizosphere activity. Meanwhile, there's humus in the soil being decomposed, and it's naturally dissolving the minerals that the plants are then recovering. So this is nature's way of extracting minerals, and we've overlooked the role of carbonic acid in the soil solution.